before I started living for God, mainly I just say that I just had a huge void in my heart and in my life, and before I completely came to Him, just kind of like all out, just like, Lord, I need You. I was just searching for a bunch of satisfaction things that just weren't there. And I mean, I'd gone to church and grew up in a Christian home, and that stuff definitely did help, because I knew the right from wrong. I knew all the stories from the Bible and all that stuff, and that stuff really is helping me now. But before I really decided for myself, which is something I think we all have to do to live for Christ, I was just basically empty. One of the main places I search for satisfaction, there are a couple places, because obviously nothing really satisfies you other than the Lord, so you kind of just keep searching, maybe bouncing around to different things. I went towards some drugs and things, and I mean, they really never did satisfy and stuff, and I had some bad relationships with girls and just a bunch of bad relationships with friends and everything. Just going out on the weekends and doing just stupid stuff that the world just finds it so wonderful and just so satisfying, but it's not satisfying. And that's what I was searching for, with satisfaction. At the lowest point in my life, I feel like God had shown me just kind of the result of that. And I just, like I said, that stuff didn't satisfy me, but I just felt a void. I didn't feel like I had any love. I didn't feel like I cared about anybody. And my mom, I care about her so much, and I just, dishonoring her day after day, lying, that stuff just, it made me hit rock bottom and say, you know, if I don't change, then, you know, I'm just gonna be this evil, kind of evil person. And so there was a night where I just feel like God showed me that, you know, it's something that I had learned in church and everything, that the result of these ways of living is gonna be death and potentially hell. There are people that planted seeds in my life, and they were seeds that I really needed. And honestly, if I didn't have those planted in me, then at these low points in my life, I wouldn't have anywhere to go to, because I wouldn't have anything else other than the things that I was chasing. If back at Heritage Christian I wasn't memorizing Bible verses, then I wouldn't know Him. And if my mom didn't show me the love of God, then I wouldn't know that love. And where else would I be other than maybe still searching? With those seeds planted in me, that I now knew that I had somewhere to go. And the Bible verses that I had memorized definitely did help. There was a night where I was at this just rock bottom, just void of living in death. And there was a night where I just burst into tears, and I was like, you know, Mom, will You pray with me? Because she had shown me God's love, and I knew that, you know, I had her to turn to. And even if people don't react as soon as you show God's love to them, they'll remember, probably. They could have someone to turn to in the future. And so I just I prayed with her, and I read Psalm 13, and it just talked about, give light to my eyes, O Lord, or I will sleep in death. And I just knew it, and it's very emotional to talk about that night, because that was mainly the main transition of my life. Since then, I definitely started started living for Jesus. You know, I wanted to make this happen. And I mean, there are a lot of things that I needed to change at that time. Just completely turning around, you know, and people were just probably wondering, like, you know, what the heck's going on with him? You know, he doesn't want to do this anymore, or does he not like me? And there's friends that I used to do really bad things with. And so at that point, I knew that, you know, I needed to stay close to God and just keep in his word and pray. And my brother had actually talked to me, and he was talking to me about all this and about the drugs and everything, and he said, you know, John, you just need to surround yourself with godly things, with godly people. And I started actually paying attention in church. It's something that is very important, and I started to grow, mainly. Since then, I feel like God's just helped me this whole way, especially whenever I made the transition. It was really hard, because I had to make the transition, and but God helped me that whole way, and it was the actual satisfaction of God that just, you know, kept me going, because it was, this is where it is, this is where it's at, it's living for Jesus. And so since then, I've just I've been growing, and people have just helped along the way so much, speaking life into me. And if it wasn't for those people that planted seeds in my life, I don't know where I'd be at. With this new transition, I was encouraged to get involved with the church. I know Christina has encouraged me, and a lot of other people, to get on the drama team, which is something that I did, and I believe that God's used me in that. And I just, to go from being at such a low place to, you know, wow, God can actually use you. It's cool. It really is. And also to now I'm on the worship team, and I'm really happy that God can just help someone, and he supplied people along the way to just help me try to get firmly planted. Now I'm going off to college. I'm going to Central Bible College. I'm really happy to go there because it's a Bible college. There's going to be lots of Christians. it's exciting, and I'm excited to see where God's going to take me. Mrs. Sims, thanks for having the teachers make us kids memorize the Bible verses. Mom, thank you for showing me God's love and for being there for me when I needed you the most. Kenny, thank you for just talking with me and just also being there for me when I needed you. Joey, thanks for being a good Christian friend when I didn't have many other guy friends that were Christians. I was counting on you. 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 I was counting on you.